goosebumpy. That was where it all began for me. As a kid, this was happening in 1992. I was probably 9 years old. And I was playing all kinds of sport. I was playing cricket, I was playing badminton, I was playing tennis, I was playing table tennis, until I finally decided to try my hand on shooting. So I visited a shooting range in Hyderabad. When I entered the shooting range, I saw pictures of all these senior shooters and stars of Indian shooting at that point of time posing with guns and weapons. By the way, that's my picture. Guns and weapons in the range. And I was quick to fill the form and take the form back to my parents. When I went back that evening, I was riding my maid's cycle on the first floor of our apartment. And I didn't have a cycle back then, so I was riding it and I was trying to take it down the first flight of stairs. Now, the only difference was I was sitting on it. I soon found myself down on the floor with the cycle on top of me and with my right wrist immovable. I caught my right wrist with my left hand and hurried back home and showed it to my dad. My dad said, "Oops, I think your right wrist is broken and I think you're going to be out of action for a couple of months now." Slowly, tears started rolling down my cheeks, not because I was in pain, but because I was thinking, how am I going to go back and shoot the next day? Well, I slept the night, and the next morning, I just quickly took a hacksaw blade and cut out a little bit of my cast. My hand was in the cast, and I went to the shooting range. The trainer over there was quite surprised to see as to how am I going to shoot. I mean, what happened to this guy? He was good yesterday, and now he has a cast around his hand. So how are you going to shoot? So I said, "No problem, I'll, you know, load the gun with my left arm." And I slowly took out the finger out of my cast and I said, "I'm going to squeeze the trigger with this. Let's begin." So that's where it all began. I soon qualified for the Athens Olympics in 2004. And I was at 21 years old, I think. And it was a dream come true for me. I mean, at Athens, I bumped into so many legends of a world sport that I would only read and see on the newspaper or on the television, like Martina Navratilova, Sergey Bubka. I mean, you name it and they were there. It was a very unique experience for me and it was very overwhelming. The highlight of the opening ceremony, or rather the Olympic Games, is the opening ceremony. And I made it to my first. It is said that the two most important days of your life are the days that you are born and the day that you know why. That torch lighting at the Barcelona Olympics in 92 and this one at Athens lit something inside me and it fueled my passion to perform for my country and to win an Olympic medal. I also later realized that my name itself had a gun in it, gun, but in the years to come, I won many medals. I was speaking at my sporting career. I was conferred the Arjuna Award in 2005. I was also world number one at that point of time. I broke many records, and I was also conferred the Padma Shri in 2010. Yet, there was a very nagging feeling inside me as to, I mean, there was a want of, you know, giving something back. I mean, I got so much out of the sport, I really wanted to give something back. How could I give back to the system that I got so much out of? And that too at the grassroots level and up. So during my pre-Olympic training in Gun for Glory in 2010, me and my friend Pawan Singh and then the coach of the Indian shooting team were just discussing in the evening. And we said, you know, what are the challenges that the sport faces? And, you know, how do we try and sort these out? Because there were so many parents who came to me and said, okay, how do I get my kid to shooting? How do I start? I didn't have an answer to give to them. So we're just discussing. And during that conversation, the seed for Gun for Glory was sown. Gun for Glory Shooting Academy was founded under the Gagan Narang Sports Promotion Foundation, which is a not-for-profit organization. At Gun for Glory, we truly believed in crafting the future. by providing world-class facilities and education at subsidized costs. The three most important aspects, rather, Gun for Glory was basically modeled around was the principles and challenges that I myself faced during my sporting career. The first being talent identifying, right guidance, and right equipment. The first being talent identification. In the year 1997, when I started shooting, a senior shooter, Mr. Niranjan Reddy, spotted the talent in me and said, I think you have the potential in you. You're shooting at targets which people shoot much later in life. And I think you need to pursue this sport and take it forward. I gladly agreed to it. But I was lucky when he spotted me and took me under his wings. I didn't wait any time. I said, sir, you know, like a shishya in front of him, I said, please teach me whatever you can. Because at that point of time, shooting was not so popular. And you could learn whatever you could from seniors and fellow shooters. So this was the first problem that we addressed in the academy, talent identification. We entered into a unique scientific talent hunt program that we took with the government of Gujarat. And we are currently working with over 5,000 school children who were tested in this unique talent hunt, out of which 30 were given full shooting scholarship. A few of them started winning medals at the state championship, and we have 32 of them who's qualified for the selection trials of the Indian team. And that too in just 1 year. This was something that I was really proud of. The second point was to get the right kind of guidance. When I started training, it was very important for me to get the right kind of guidance. I was shooting an event which was called the Open Sight Air Rifle, and that event was only up to the national championship. But Mr. Niranjan Reddy at that point of time asked me to shift my event to the Peep Sight Air Rifle, which was then an Olympic event. I was also advised to change and upgrade my equipment as I was shooting with ancient equipment. I changed my event to Peep Sight, and I went to the competition that I had to go to. I didn't win any medals. I came back empty-handed. I argued with him and I said, why did you ask me to change? I was winning medals in the other event. But I soon realized that after a few years, I would eventually have to move to a Peep Sight event. I was very fortunate to get the right kind of guidance from him. But I have seen so many athletes, so many talented shooters, who, because of not getting the right kind of guidance, got frustrated and quit the sport. This challenge we addressed in Gun for Glory by getting in foreign coaches. At that point of time, we thought, why should just the top shooters have access to foreign coaching? We got in foreign coaches into India. We taught them the ways of Indian lifestyle and how to educate Indian kids. And soon we were in a program that was people had access to, I mean, at a very subsidized cost, probably 1/10 the cost of what it would cost for me to go abroad and train. And the unique and the best part about this was we won 94 international medals out of this program. We also later came up with a very structured course called the First Shot, the Reload, and the Bullseye. Now, this program was structured around, for example, class 1, class 2, and class 3. I mean, when you go into education, what do? You start. You can't start from class 7, so you have to start from class 1. So we structured the program in a way that you would have basic education, intermediate, and then the level 3 program, which gives you the knowledge to go into the national championships. Shooters now were given the right kind of guidance, whether to choose between rifle or pistol, which event category will work for them, and how to continue in the right way. The third and the most difficult challenge that I faced was the right equipment. In the year 2002, I had already won a few medals, and at the All India level. And I was knocking at the doors of the Indian team. One fine day, I went into the range, and there was a fellow shooter who got his new, brand new imported gun from Germany. And I was looking with my tongue out, wanting to touch the rifle and wanting to shoot. When am I going to get my hand to shoot that? So he said, okay, why don't you shoot a competition with it? He was very forthcoming, and he asked me to shoot with it. And I shoot 20 points more than what I was shooting. And I realized that I wasn't shooting as good as I can because I didn't have the right equipment. I went back home and I pleaded my parents, please, please buy me a gun. I'm not able to shoot. You know, I pleaded them. They said, 1 year he's doing cricket, the other he is doing badminton, the third year he's doing table tennis. We buy him a gun, what if he changed to kabaddi or something? So they took their own sweet time, but they finally got me a gun, which costed 1.5 lakh rupees that time. 1.5 lakh is 150,000 Indian rupees. Well, that was my first rifle, and it was a Walther. A small trivia for all of you, Walther is the same brand that James Bond uses in his movies. But it was only later that I realized that they had to sell a plot of land to buy a gun for me. This land was the piece of land that we had to build our own house on, and we stayed on rented accommodation after that for 20 years because they sold that land to buy a gun. And I can never thank them enough for their sacrifice. They didn't know how I would be. They didn't know if I would win a medal or not in the future, but they just didn't wanted to see a smile on my face. And that's the reason why I am who I am because of them. I'm really, really thankful to what they did. Inside of me, I never wanted a parent to sell his land to buy a gun. At Gun for Glory, we were barely managing at that point of time to stay afloat, leave alone buying rifles and equipment for our kids. We spoke to Walther and we asked for their support. And Walther now sponsors weapons for all Gun for Glory academies. This magnanimous gesture by Walther kept the costs low for people who wanted to take to the sport. And I'm proud to say that today no parent needs to sell his land or house to help their children start shooting. We brought the cost down of a level one program to under 5,000 rupees, which costed me 1.5 lakh then. We all face many challenges in our lives. For some of us, every day is a challenge. Each day of our life throws different challenges on us and situations that we learn to emerge out of. One such challenge I faced when I was a favorite going into the Beijing Olympics in 2008. I was world number one, having won a medal fresh out of the pre-Olympic World Cup. But luck again was not on my side. And a shot 8.9 in the qualification out of a 10 in one of the shots and finished 9th. Top 8 shooters qualify for the final. But I had the same score as the guys who were on 5th, 6th, 7th and 8th position. I missed an Olympic final despite having the same score as 4 others. Now to give you an idea of what it feels like and how narrowly I missed, you all have been given a card. Everybody has the card. That's the 10-meter air rifle target we shoot at from 10 meters away in the Olympics. And the bullseye is that small tiny dot that you see in the center. So imagine I'm holding a card here and you're sitting 10 meters away and you have to shoot that tiny little dot. So one of the shots in my competition was an 8.9. If it had been a 9.0, I would have been at the same score as Abhinav, and who knows what would have happened then. Abhinav definitely went on to win a medal and create history for India. But just to explain you what 8.9 and a 9.0 meant was this. So if you pick the strand of your hair, you know, shot this side or that side, you would know how narrowly I missed. We were very happy that, you know, India has won our first Olympic medal, but soon the happiness was turned into depression for me. I came back home. I had to handle the trauma of my mother being hospitalized. I didn't know what was worse, my miss at the Olympics or the situation at home. But I gathered myself again. I gathered all the broken pieces in my heart from Beijing and pulled myself back together. And I prepared to shoot at the World Cup final in Bangkok in 2008, 2 months later. And bang. .600 out of .600 was an equal world record. And I shattered the final world record by 703.5 and became the world record holder. I didn't win an Olympic medal, but I had a world record to my name. And it stands to this day. The loss at Beijing fueled the fire inside me for London. And I shot my first Olympic medal in 2012, London. This adversity taught me much. Shooting doesn't make you an aggressive person. It helps you to develop patience and helps you temper your emotions. The high level of discipline that is required in the sport makes one very, very resilient to adversity. No athlete will be able to reach this level without a complete support system, a support system that is a non-technical one. I too struggled in this section, but Olympic Gold Quest came to my help and supported me. They have also built and supported me since 2008. They gave me a dietitian, a masseur, a mental trainer, and a physiotherapist. Did I say a dietitian? Never mind. All of which mattered to me at that point of time to reach the highest level. This also allowed me to focus on my sport of shooting and not worry about anything else. Gun for Glory works on a similar system of providing an all-rounded approach to our kids. The another aspect, an integral part of a sportsman life is to balance sport and education. I stood at a point where I had to decide whether I would continue to shoot sport or continue to finish my basic education. And I didn't know what I was supposed to do. Children often have to wait until they finish their education and get into sport. And at that level, they're already too late for sport. So we designed a state-of-the-art in-school program which complemented education so that kids could learn the sport in shooting. The ecosystem that we created will allow any shooter to achieve his full potential. I am Gagan Narang. This is the story of how I intend to craft our future.